The main point of what I just showed you is that instead of looking at all possible paths, by using recursion, we can look at n squared t paths. And remember, the reason we can do this recursion is that that recursive formula only looks back at the previous state. We're taking advantage of that Markovian property. And with just the forward algorithm, we could evaluate the probability of seeing that entire observation sequence given the machine. So, for example, and I haven't yet told you how to do this, if we had trained up a bunch of HMMs and some new observation sequence comes in, I could have told you which one was most likely using just the forward recursive algorithm, right? It requires the A's and the B's, but that's what it means to have trained up the HMM. So I want to tell you about the rest of the problems, but I'm just going to tell it to you in words. I'm not going to give you the math. And you can go look. There are a bunch of tutorials on HMMs out there if you want to do the math. They're pretty straightforward, all right? So the forward recursive algorithm that I just showed you can compute the likelihood of being in state I at time t and having seen all the observations up to time t, given that you have the HMM lambda. You can similarly define a backward algorithm, all right? Just sort of starts from the back and goes backwards instead of the front. And it's a recursive algorithm that computes the likelihood of being at state time t and seeing the remainder of the observations. Again, given the HMM.